Here, welcome. We're at the Warren for a change. What do you think of the Warren?
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
It's brilliant. Yeah, I'm just really enjoying seeing who's here, and there's a lot of great energy and atmosphere. It's brilliant.
And this is, of course, Sarah, who knows everything about jazz. What's happening this week, Sarah?
So tonight at the Verdict, Terry Seabrook and his quintet are playing. And we've got a clip.
Let's have
a look.
Right, let's watch. Seabrook is amazing, isn't he? And this is Wayne Shorter?
Wayne Shorter, they're playing one by one there. And so basically, this quintet did a recording in last year, and they tour celebrating the music of Wayne Shorter. And he's one of the most prolific jazz composers there's ever been. He's 85 now. So it's going to be a fantastic night. Andy Panay is playing sax and flute. It's a brilliant quintet. And definitely one not to miss, because, you know, it's celebrating the life and work of Wayne Shorter, and there's some compositions originally composed by Terry, inspired by Wayne Shorter. So it's a full gamut of Wayne Shorter, basically, yeah.
I saw Terry and Andy actually last week at the Snowdrop. They were playing together on other stuff.
Yeah.
So they play together frequently.
They do. In fact, I was going to mention on Monday, Jason Henson is joining Terry at the Snowdrop, his regular Monday night thing, and Darren Beckett will be playing with them as well. So that's
enough. Who?
I don't know. This guy keeps cropping up every week.
Okay. And you've got another show that you want to recommend to us this
yes.
week?
Yes. There's a really fantastic one to get to in Worthing. It's the Ronnie Scott's All Stars.
You've got a clip.
Yes.
Let's watch.
Here in my heart, one day I'll fly away and leave your love to yesterday. What more can your love do for me?
Ronnie Scott, of course, well known for being, you know, the main club in the UK, but also an amazing musician, and more or less put jazz on the map in the UK.
Absolutely. Celebrating the 60th anniversary in October this year, so the All Stars are touring the country at the moment, and this show is going to be spectacular. It's a two-hour show, loads of performances, obviously, but also rare footage. There'll be screens where we'll be watching film of going right back to the inception of Ronnie Scott's, and, you know, where there were police raids and the scrapes with gangsters, the craze were involved at one point.
I'll probably be in here then.
Yeah, I'm sure you'll get a mention. Just an incredible night of just 60 years, and everyone's played at Ronnie Scott's. So there'll be some amazing footage of Ella Fitzgerald and, yeah, all kinds of people.
The history of Soho.
Absolutely, yeah. So I highly recommend that.
Sadly under threat now, Soho, isn't it, really? A lot of the main venues are.
That's the way it is difficult. In capitals. Same in New York, you know. It's a shame, but hopefully they'll survive. They've survived 60 years, so.
And lots of free music, though, in the venues in Brighton. So.
Yes, there's some free things to go and see this weekend. Imogen Ryle, who's one of my favourite singers, and Julian Nicholas, they'll be in Hove at All Saints Church at 1 o'clock on Saturday. So get down there and then head over to the Paris House to see Lawrence Jones. And again, Darren Beckett will be playing with him. He's at 4 o'clock. And then I mentioned Terry's regular night on Mondays. That's definitely one to get to.
Thank you, Sarah. Sarah will be back next week to talk more about jazz across Sussex and maybe have her own show quite soon. I can slope off and do something else. Have fun.